Hello, today's daily reading comes from the book of the Apocrypha. We are reading from the book of Jasher, chapter 16, and it reads as follows. At that time, Chedorlaomer, king of Elam, sent to all the neighboring kings, to Nimrod, king of Shinar, who was then under his power, and to Tidal, king of Goyim, and to Arioch, king of Elazar, with whom he made a covenant, saying, "Come up to me and assist me, that we may smite all the towns of Sodom and its inhabitants, for they have rebelled against me these 13 years. And these four kings went up with all their camps, about 800,000 men. And they went as they were, and smote every man they found in their road. And the five kings of Sodom and Gomorrah, Shinab, king of Admah, Shemeber, king of Zeboiim, Bera, king of Sodom, Bersha, king of Gomorrah, and Bela, king of Zoar, went out to meet them. And they all joined together in the valley of Siddim. And these nine kings made war on the valley of Siddim, and the kings of Sodom and Gomorrah were smitten before the kings of Elam, and the valley of Siddim was full of lime pits, and the kings of Elam pursued the kings of Sodom, and the kings of Sodom with their camps fled and fell into the lime pits, and all that remained went to the mountain for safety. And the five kings of Elam came after them and pursued them to the gates of Sodom, and they took all that there was in Sodom, and they plundered all the cities of Sodom and Gomorrah. They also took Lot, Abram's brother's son, and his property, and they seized all the goods of the cities of Sodom, and they went away. And Eunuch, Abram's servant, who was in the battle, saw this and told Abram all the things the kings had done to the cities of Sodom, and that Lot was taken captive to them. And Abram heard this, and he rose up with about 318 men that were with him, and he that night pursued these kings and smote them. And they all fell before Abram and his men, and there was none remaining but the four kings who fled, and they went each his own way road. And Abram recovered all the property of Sodom, and he also recovered Lot and his property, his wives and little ones, and all belonging to him, so that Lot lacked nothing. And when he returned from smiting these kings, he and his men passed the valley of Siddim, where the kings had made war together. And Bera, king of Sodom, and the rest of his men that were with him went out from the lime pits into which they had fallen to meet Abram and his men. And Elzenadek, king of Jerusalem, the same with Shem, went out with his men to meet Abram and his people with bread and wine, and they remained together in the valley of Melech. And Adonizedek blessed Abram. And Abram gave him a tenth from all that he had brought from the spoil of his enemies, for Adonizedek was a priest before God. And all the kings of Sodom and Gomorrah who were there, where the servants approached Abram and begged of him to return them their servants whom he had made captive, and to take unto them himself all the property. And Abram answered the kings of Sodom, saying, "As the Lord lives, who created heaven and earth, and who redeemed my soul from all affliction, and who delivered me this day from my enemies and gave them into my hand, I will not take anything belonging to you, that you may not boast tomorrow, saying, 'Abram became rich from our property that he saved.' For the Lord my God, in whom I trust, said unto me, 'You will lack nothing, for I will bless you in all the works of your hands.' And now therefore, behold, here is all belonging to you. Take it and go. As the Lord lives, I will not take from you, from a living soul down to a shuttai or thread, expecting the expense of the food of those who went out with me to battle, as also the portions of the men who went with me, Anar, Ashkal, and Mamre. They and their men, as well as those who remained to watch the baggage, they will take their portion of the spoil." And the kings of Sodom gave Abram according to all that he had said, and they passed him to take of whatever he chose, but he would not. And he sent away the kings of Sodom and then the remainder of their men, and he gave them orders about Lot. And they went to their respective places. And Lot, his brother's sons, he also sent away with his property, and he went with them. And Lot returned to his home to Sodom, and Abram and his people returned to their home to the plains of Mamre, which is in Hebron. At that time the Lord again appeared to Abram in Hebron, and he said to them, "Do not fear, your reward is very great before me, for I will not leave you until I have multiplied you and blessed you and made you seed like the stars in heaven which cannot be measured nor numbered. And I will give unto your seed all these lands that you see with your eyes, to them will I give them for an inheritance forever. Only be strong and do not fear. Walk before me and be perfect. And in the 78th year of the life of Abram, in that year did Reu, the son of Peleg, and all the days of Reu were 239 years, and he died. And Sarai, the daughter of Haran, Abram's wife, was still barren in those days. She did not bear to Abram either son or daughter. And when she saw that she bore no children, she took her handmaid Hagar, whom Pharaoh had given her, and she gave her to Abram, her husband, for a wife. For Hagar learned all the ways of Sarai as Sarai taught her. She was not in any way deficient in following her good ways. And Sarai said to Abram, "Behold, here is my handmaid Hagar. Go to her, that she may bring out upon my knees, that I may also obtain children through her." And at that end of the 10 years of Abram's dwelling in the land of Canaan, which is the 85th year of Abram's life, Sarai gave Hagar unto him. And Abram hearkened in the voice of his wife Sarai, and he took his handmaid Hagar, and Abram came to her, and she conceived. And when Hagar saw that she had conceived, she rejoiced greatly, and her mistress was despised in her eyes, and she said within herself, "This can only be that I am better before God than Sarai, my mistress. For all the days that my mistress has been with my lord, she did not conceive. But me the Lord has caused in so short a time to conceive by him." And when Sarai saw that Hagar had conceived by Abram, Sarai was jealous of her handmaid. And Sarai said within herself, "This is surely nothing else but that she must be better than I am." And Sarai said unto Abram, "My wrong be upon you, for at the time when you did pray before the Lord for children, why did you not pray on my account, that the Lord should give me seed from you? And when I speak to Hagar in your presence, she despises my words, because she has conceived, and you will say nothing to her. May the Lord judge between me and you for what you have done to me." And Abram said to Sarai, "Behold, your handmaid is in your hands. Do unto her as it may seem good in your eyes." And Sarai afflicted her, and Hagar fled from her to the wilderness. And an angel of the Lord found her in the place where she had fled by a well, and he said to her, "Do not fear, for I will multiply your seed, for you will bear a son, and you will call his name Ishmael. Now then return to Sarai your mistress, and submit yourself under her hands." And Hagar called the place of that well Beer Lashidaroi. It is between Kadesh and the wilderness Bered. And Hagar at the time returned to her master's house, and at the end of the days Hagar bore a son to Abram. And Abram called his name Ishmael. And Abram was 86 years old when he begot him. Amen.